Hi, I'm Bonnie Francis, and we're talking about events that are happening here in Queen Anne's County. One of the events that happens in May is our Senior Summit. It will be happening on May 15th at the 4-H Park here in Centerville. I have with me today Mary Alice Van Hoy, who works at the Shore Regional Emergency Center located in Queenstown. So welcome.
Hi.
Thanks for coming in.
Thank you for inviting me today.
First off, tell us about the Emergency Center and any services that have changed down there, what's available, that type of thing. Not that we want people there, but it's good that we have the facility.
Great. Shore Emergency Center Queenstown is part of the Shore Regional Health Center. We're now on our fifth year since we've been open. We're very excited about that.
Yeah.
It's growing.
That, yeah.
It's growing. Like you said, we really don't want to see you, but if you need us, we're there.
Right.
And that's a big piece of it. We're there for our community, there for our neighbors. And we have been fairly busy recently. University of Maryland Shore Regional Health has redone its strategic plan and mission. And I think its mission really defines why we, the Shore Emergency Center, are there. Their mission is creating healthier communities together.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And it really focuses, I think, on what we do.
Okay.
We are there. We're taking care of our friends. We're taking care of our neighbors. And we're there for the community, no matter what happens.
Right.
During all the bridge closures, we're open. During Hurricane Sandy, we were open.
Right.
During all those winter storms, we were there. New things going on. We're continuing to grow, which is very nice. One thing is that we this year obtained our Maryland MEMS-approved base station, which means now the ambulances have a quicker turnaround time.
Okay.
They can come to our facilities, and it's really that continuity of care. They talk to the doctor who's going to be taking care of them from the ambulance, and then we continue that care.
Okay.
So that's really a positive for us. With that, we're still following the same trend, quality health care, regionalized, personalized for the patient, easy, accessible, and convenient.
Right.
We've expanded our population now, includes not only those in Queen Anne's County, but we have Talbot County people, Caroline County people, people from across the bridge even come for our health care now. So we are very proud that we're able to do that.
Well, it's nice to have a facility so close.
It is.
Because before people would have to travel a longer distance and, you know, things can happen in a quick period of time and, you know, you want to have a facility that you can get to locally.
And we're glad we're there. I personally believe that those few minutes, 20-30 minute drive has made a significant difference in people's lives.
Right.
And it actually has saved a few lives too. So we're very proud of that. Then we've developed all the new partnerships within not only Shore Regional Health, but the community as well and all that community base.
Right.
The development and the expansion of the Shore Medical Pavilion behind us has been fantastic. In December, the University of Maryland Shore Surgical Center opened, and since then they've been very busy. It's the latest generation high-tech surgery equipment that you may need for outpatient surgery.
Right.
They're doing orthopedics, they're doing gastroenterological stuff, urology, pain management. So it's getting to the point now for your health care, you can just come to the pavilion.
Right.
From primary care through specialty care. If you need diagnostics, we have CAT scan, we have MRI, we have now a surgery center. So it's really bringing the resources to the community that they really need.
Right.
And I'm excited.
I know one time I took my granddaughter over there. She had to have blood work done because she was going to have surgery coming up. And, you know, it was nice because it was very close.
It's convenient. You don't have to fight the traffic either way. So I think it's really better. And for some, since we are talking about the senior celebration coming up, for some of our seniors who don't feel comfortable making that long drive, we now have resources for them within our county.
So and one of the things that could help them if they need to get like to the pavilion, they can contact County Ride.
Correct.
And get a ride there that would be convenient for them.
And we see the County Ride bus dropping people off frequently. And occasionally they will leave them, drop people off to us.
Really?
So it is. Yeah. Somebody wants some care, they can't get access, they don't feel comfortable calling 911 for it. So they've got the County Ride bus and they've brought them in.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting.
Yeah, it was interesting to watch the county ride bus. And then we also utilize our resources to sometimes take people home if we can't arrange transportation for them.
Okay.
So it is a great asset that we have there in the county.
So when you come to the Senior Summit,
okay,
what types of things can people pick up at your table?
Well, at our table, our emergency center, we really focus on wellness and prevention.
Right.
Not that I'd rather see you out in town somewhere than see you in my building. So our focus this year is going to be on senior falls.
Okay.
It's such a big issue. What we're finding is that people are coming in from incidents that occur in their home. It's not unusual. Millions of people over the age of 65 fall every year. And one thing we're finding is that they're reluctant to share that information with their healthcare provider. So sometimes they'll fall and they'll fall repeatedly. And our concern is that one fall, they may break a hip, which is something we always hear.
Right.
But we also get broken shoulders, broken arms, and the potential for head injuries. And if someone is already on an anticoagulant, some type of blood thinner that makes them bleed a little longer, and then they fall and hit their head, they could be really at great risk.
Right.
So we're going to focus on fall prevention. Big things like trip hazards.
Okay.
Look at your house. What's in your house? You walk in. Is your throw rug on the floor double-sided sticky tape? Something simple like that. You walk into some homes, and I'm just as guilty, there may be a newspaper or a magazine on the floor. How many times have you walked by and hit one of those and started scooting along the floor? Looking at your lighting. Is there sufficient lighting, especially around steps? And you'll see that people with steps will talk about putting something discolored.
Right.
If you got pretty carpet, put a different color on so you can
determine the depth
because a couple little slips and down a few flights of steps. Steps are another thing. Handrails.
Right.
Not only one.
But two.
But two.
Right.
Which one is your dominant side? If you use your dominant side going up, you need to be able to use your dominant side going down. Vision. Sometimes your vision can throw things off, so you might not be able to see. You might miss that trip hazard. The other day, somebody tripped over their cat. We've had them falling over their pets.
Right.
So we worry about that. Maybe medications. A lot of people take different meds nowadays. And do those medications make you dizzy or lightheaded when you stand up? Do we need to stand up slower? So that's another thing. But not only do we talk about what the trip hazards are, we also want to focus on what can you do? What can every person do to decrease that risk?
So one of the first things they want to do is just take a look.
Look around.
And
we're going to give them a check sheet to take home with them. And say, here's a little check sheet, just go check your house. Because if I tell you five things,
you might remember three.
Oh, I was going to be nice and say maybe one or two. But I'm going to send you home with a check sheet.
Right.
So that you can go and walk in your door and look at your rugs, look at your plugs, look at your cords, look at your pets, look at the stuff on the floor, and go walk through each one of those things. Because I think that's real important. I would rather you remember one or two things, check a few things, and that might decrease your risk of injury.
Right.
So I think that's real important for our population.
Well, that's a good thing.
Oh, yes. And it's not just seniors.
Right.
Because
right.
I challenge these people to go home and share this information with their children, mm-hmm. their grandchildren, their neighbors, whomever, because if we can decrease, if all this information we get out and we cut one fall, then it's a win for us.
Right. Right.
But we also have to look at what wellness things they can do. Simple things like exercise.
Mm-hmm.
Getting out and walking improves your balance. Improving your balance decreases your fall risk.
Right.
So things like that. Non-skid socks. Not going barefoot.
Right.
All of those things come into mind. So that's what we talked it over with the staff, and that's what they wanted to do this year. Each year, I ask the staff what they think.
Right.
What have we seen? What do we need to address?
Right.
And falls was this year.
Well, that's a good topic because there's a lot that people can do to prevent.
Very much so. Very much so. And you just have to bring it to their attention.
Right.
Because you might think about it walking in, but if I have told you about it, you may go home and just eyeball and look. We even have a game this year that there's 14 things wrong on the picture. Can you pick out what's wrong?
Oh, that's good.
So it's a visual cue.
Well, and also gets them memory looking at what would be right and what's not right.
Right, because everybody learns differently.
Right.
Some people will learn off that check sheet. But if you physically see something and you can cue it, it cues in a different part of your brain.
Right.
Which also stimulates brain activity, which is a good thing as well. So that's kind of what our goal is. We'll probably throw in just a little bit to double check and make sure they got smoke detectors. And now focus also, think about your carbon monoxide detectors as well.
Right.
Just in home safety, home injury prevention in general.
So, all right.
So that's ours. But
That'll be good.
Yeah. But we do have some of our other members of Shore Regional Health that are coming as well.
Right.
We'll have the University of Maryland Shore Nursing and Rehab Center in Chestertown. They will be there. We'll have Shore Comprehensive Urology, Shore Rehab, who is right there in Queenstown, and they also have a great view of Route 50 from their rehab center. The Breast Center, the Cancer Center, the Pain Center, Shore Wellness Partners, who has a community outreach all of their own.
Right.
If somebody has a question about diabetes and their management, we'll have a diabetes educator there. So they can ask some questions.
Now, they're all going to be at separate tables.
Separate tables. Oh, yeah. You'll come in and we'll be like a Shore Regional Health row right there for everybody.
Like a compound.
Like a compound. You can stop and you just stop along the way. We'll also have someone there from our stroke center to talk about stroke prevention.
Oh, that's good.
Which actually goes in well with our fall prevention.
Right.
But, yeah, we hope that people stop by, get a little information, learn a little bit about us. New name, Shore Regional Health. Will be something that, you know, they can pick up on, but we're there for the community.
Right.
We're there for creating healthier communities together.
Well,
that's our goal.
So they know what's available in case they need it.
Right.
You know, it's right here in our county.
It's here in our region.
Right.
We have what you need.
Right.
Let us serve you. Let us make healthier lives together. And that's what we'd like to do.
Well, thank you for coming in.
Glad you invited me. We'll see you in a few weeks.
Yeah.